with that, Valor fans, we welcome you once again inside of Bill Greehey Arena. Our final matchup of the night between the St. Mary's Rattlers and the St. Edward's University Hilltoppers. The Battle of the Saints about to get underway. St. Mary's entering play today, a record of 8-14, 4-10 in Heartland Conference play. Currently, they hold on to that number 8 seed in the Heartland Conference tournament. Meanwhile, St. Edward's a record of 15-7 overall. They are 8-6 in Heartland Conference play, and they're currently that number 5 seed. I'm Joe Rodriguez. Once again, big Heartland Conference expectations put onto this one, and for the Rattlers, home sweet home as we're underway, and the tip will be won by the guys in gold. Starting for the Rattlers, Bryce Smith, Christian Miner, the guards, McGlown out there at small forward. It's going to be Wetzel and Woodhill, the two bigs out there on the floor. McGlown driving, trying to get down low, picked up his dribble, and now here's Miner with the ball, down to 10 seconds on the shot clock. Miner, the pass, good job by him as Wetzel will put it up with the left hand for two. The starting five for the Hilltoppers, it's going to be Gramlich, McBlueview, Gilbert, Burton, and Lindsay. The Rattlers coming out of trapping defense. This one put up for three and good. A freebie there for Trey Lindsay. 3-2 as we're getting started fast and furious here. These two teams matched up at St. Edward's earlier on in the year. The Hilltoppers able to hold home court there. They're victorious 69-65 in that ball game. But tonight, the Rattlers will look for redemption as McGlown, a in-stride jumper, no good. The board is battled for, and Gilbert will come down with it. Here comes McBlueview now trying to push the pace, working up against McGlown. Another shot put up, this time draws nothing but air. Smith, he'll let it go out of bounds as Trey Lindsay tried to knock down a shot from the same spot on the floor. Unable to do so, 18:40 remaining here on the game clock. For St. Mary's, home has been their safe place. They're 7-3 at home so far on the year. The guys really just having a tough go at it on the road so far this season. They've yet to win a game on the road, as that one will be last touched by Lockie Woodhill. The freshman tandem in the front court today for St. Mary's. St. Mary's, we typically see them, they've gone with the smaller kind of approach, playing more of a prototypical three in the four position across the year, but now they're starting both of their big guys, their foreigners, as a nice board taken down there by Wetzel. Here's Smith up there at the top of the floor. He's had himself a very nice season. McGlown, oh, the bobble. And now it's off to the races. Burton ahead of the field. The left hand put up. And McGlown, he'll commit the foul right there. That's a bad foul there by AJ. If you're going to foul him down there in transition, you got to give him a better whack than that one there. A chance for the three-point play now for Burton, who did a good job of using his body there on that fast break. Burton, he's averaging 14.7 points per game for the St. Edward's team. That's the best scoring average for the side of the Hilltoppers. As he'll put that one in, and 7-2, quickly the advantage for St. Ed's. If you missed it, the first game of our Battle of the Saints, it was the Lady Rattlers who came out victorious. After trailing by double digits in that ball game, they managed to pull it out and win by two. Here's an aggressive attack, but a good job of cutting off the angle there by Lindsay. As Wetzel, he got caught up, and the ball will be out on him. Once again, possession on over for St. Ed's. For St. Mary's, they're a team that plays a little bit of a more defensive style than St. Edward's, as Lindsay, once again, that one put up, but no good. This time it will be Woodhill who gets beat. But Lindsay, he's come out and been very aggressive here in the early going of things, as he'll now head to the free throw line. Lindsay, averaging 7.9 points on the year, is the first one no good out of him. Also has 4.8 rebounds to go along with it. For the St. Edward's team, not really any standout rebounders on their team. They do it by a committee. Everyone on their team who plays significant minutes, averaging anywhere between 5.8 and 2.3 rebounds per game. Smith, he'll pass it on out to McGlown. AJ, he'll get the screen, drive into the paint. Smith fakes the shot. Now down to 13 seconds on the shot clock. Smith, he has it tapped away. A good defensive play there by Gramlich, and now here comes McBlueu in transition. Pass out for three. No good there for Gilbert. The Rattlers got away with one there in transition. Smith working up against Gramlich yet again. An offensive foul going to be called there, as it looks like Woodhill may have been a bit too aggressive down low, and that's already his second personal foul in just 3 minutes and 12 seconds of playing time. And it looks like Coach Selznak is now going to insert someone into the lineup, going to try to, but Woodhill, he's got to play very careful here until the next whistle. Here's Smith now bringing it on down the floor. Looking for McGlown, he has him. Trying to get it down low here to Woodhill, but not able to do so. Here's Smith now, 4-3, no good. Rebound taken down by McBlueu. Here he goes in transition. He's been a blur so far here today, really trying to push that pace. Now here's Gramlich. Good defense there by Smith to get a piece of it. And now Lindsay with it out there on that corner. Pass back out to Lindsay, 4-3, no good there, as it will be Miner who takes down the board there. Here's Smith now, top of the key. We're 5 minutes, or we're just a touch under 5 minutes into this one. A double team drawn here by Wetzel. He'll take a dribble away from it, and now they'll try to reposition the big man. It's swatted away by Lindsay, and you see Lindsay shaking his head there. And now the pass up to McBlueu. He hits the floor and is holding his shoulder as he's gone down. Rattlers are going to have a 5v4 here temporarily. A foul will be committed by the side of St. Edward's. But McBlueu, he's down on the floor and grabbing at that left shoulder. It will be a media timeout with 15:23 remaining here on the floor. We hope McBlueu will be fine when we return here on the Rattler Network. And welcome back, everyone. I think you can see McBlueu there on the left side of your screen. He managed to regain his feet. He's very gingerly walking over towards that St. Edward's trainer's table. We hope that he is fine, but taking his place, it will be Sean Watkins checking into the game. 6-2 the lead here for the Hilltoppers with 15:23 remaining in the first half. We're ready to get back to things. Also checking into the game for St. Mary's, it's going to be Stefan Wright, as he'll be replacing Lockie Woodhill. Woodhill, who already has two fouls on the game, will be getting a brief break. So we're ready to get back to things now. And for St. Mary's, we mentioned that home has been their place where they've played their best. 7-3 at home so far on the year. You know, the Rattlers would love to try to improve their seed before heading into that Heartland Conference tournament. Right now, they currently sit on that 8 seed as an inbounds play to Miner. He'll splash on in the 3. And that's what I like to see out of the Rattlers. It seems like whenever they get off to the best starts, it's because Christian Miner, he's out and firing early. But Christian had been held scoreless up until this point here. Pass on out. That's now back up top. It's over to Burton now. Burton, he'll be guarded by Miner. Kick on out over to Lindsay. Lindsay guarded by Wright. And Burton comes down with the rebound, manages to beat the shot clock after the air ball, and the rebound will be taken down by Wetzel. So here comes Smith now. Passes it over to Wright. Wright up there in the high post. Pass to McGlown. It's an errant one, and battling for it for St. Edwards was Watkins. Not able to come up with it, and it will be Rattler basketball now. Bryce Smith to inbound here. It's over to McGlown. Pass off to Wetzel now. Now here's McGlown. Wetzel, he'll drive baseline, tries to get underneath the hoop and manages to do so. A strong challenge by Gilbert, but Wetzel is able to beat it nonetheless. And it's the first lead of the night now for the Rattlers. Good move there by Gramlich. Passes off to Lindsay, now to Watkins. Here we go to Burton now. They're trying to get Lindsay's position down low, up against Wright. He faces him up, and a good job there of playing the passing lanes. That's Miner who is getting involved on that pass off to Watkins. Here's Bryce Smith with it now. This one put up from mid-range and good out of Christian Miner. 9-6 now for St. Mary's. This St. Mary's basketball team, a very storied history out of them, a NCAA national, a national championship, I should say. As this one, ooh, a foul called, though. I think they might get right for the action down low. But the reason I bring it up is we were talking about retired jerseys at the retirement of Kim Klings on Thursday. She was only the second female athlete and the second softball player to have her Rattler jersey retired out of 12 people. And if you look around at the rafters, 9 out of the 12 jerseys that have been retired are out of this men's basketball program. So a very nice history for them as that first free throw has been knocked down by Gilbert. Givens, he's checked into the game along with Skylar Brooks. And then Trey Hall, he's also headed into the game for the first time today. Second free throw knocked in good as well. And then Quentin Lilly, he checked into the game for Trey Lindsay as well. Jiminy passes it off. Now here's Hall. Good, strong move out of him. He'll get the finish for 2. Here we go the other way. Now it's Gramlich. Passes it on off to Lilly. Now here's Watkins with it now. Pass off to Burton. He has Lilly down low. Lilly up against Wright. Gets the finish and the foul. Wright trying to say he was straight up, but that will be on him and will be his second personal as well. And already the Rattler big men in some foul trouble here. Lilly, he'll now head to the free throw line. They're not going to substitute for Wright here, which is surprising. It's quite some foul trouble to be in here early. As they'll inbound now to Givens as the game has been tied up at 11. Pass on off to Brooks. He's trapped. That's a bad spot to be, but fortunately able to step through the double team, and now the Rattlers will reset with 18 on the shot clock. Pass on off to Hall. He'll pass it off to Brooks now. Givens. Just 9 seconds here on the shot clock. Here's Miner hanging, finishing. Christian Miner. The hoop plus the harm as he's now up to 5 points on the night. Good ball movement there out of St. Mary's. Everyone touched it on that possession right there. And now Miner, he'll head to the line with a chance to finish off the 3-point play. Miner leads this Rutler team in scoring with 14.1 points per game as he'll sink that one. And now we'll see Hudson McGashin checking into the game here for Stephon Wright. Hudson, he's had limited action thus far this season, been averaging 3.8 minutes per game. But in that time, he's been contributing decently on the boards. Perhaps some extended action tonight with the foul trouble out of the Rattler bigs. 9 seconds now on the shot clock. This one swatted away by Hall, but able to get it back is Gramlich, and he'll finish. Just underneath 12 minutes remaining here in the first half. Rattler still with a one-point lead. The pace of this one really starting to pick up as these two teams are done feeling each other out. Here's Brooks now. He's going to drive to the lane. A blocking foul is going to be called. It looks like they're going to get Gilbert on that one there. No continuation given to Brooks, otherwise he would have had the and one. And that'll take us to our second media timeout of the half. We'll take the break as the Rattlers lead at 14-13 here on the Rattler Network. And welcome back, everyone. 11:43 remaining here in the first half. St. Mary's and the Hilltoppers back and forth action, just like we saw in the first game of this doubleheader. And you wouldn't really expect less, as these two teams have been battling it out over the course of the past few seasons. And really all sports, it's been St. Mary's and St. Edward's who always seem to find ways to put together big time important games, as Gibbons, he'll fake the shot right there, and we're back into the action. Jimney, that shot put up well strong. McGashin looked like he had a shot at the rebound there, but not able to come away with it, as it will be Burton who does so. So now here's Burton, he's working up against Brooks, pass into the corner for Gramlich, open three, no good. Hall, he had a chance at it, but not able to take it down cleanly. Watkins gets in there, and it'll be a jump ball and extra possession on over for the Hilltoppers now. 11:16 remaining in the half. It will be a new shot clock for the Hilltoppers, as they will say that Hall had enough of possession there to reset the shot clock. Now a substitution here, and it will be Isaiah Perros checking on into the game for Miner. Miner, he'll get his first breather of the game. It's a full bench on out there for St. Mary's right now. This one inbounded over towards Burton. Working up against Perros. This one knocked away, and it is saved, but into the hands of a Hilltopper. And now down low with it was Lilly temporarily. Here's Gramlich. He'll drive in, drops it on off, put up and in for the easy two for Burton. Inbound now to Gibbons. Gibbons, Brooks, Perros, Hall, and McGashin, the five on the floor for St. Mary's. Gibbons, big step through. Here's Hall now. Pass off to Perros. Perros, he'll drive, hang, and finish for two. So we keep springing back and forth. It's like a game of ping pong here with both teams just going up by one, up by two, and then the lead just changing on over. Good pump fake there out of Taylor. Not able to do anything with it, though. It's passed out to Burton, working against Peros, and he'll draw the foul. That foul's going to be the 16th foul committed by St. Mary's, and as such, the Hilltoppers will be shooting 1-1 at least for the remainder of the half upon the next foul. It's a lot of fouls to be committing with just 10-16 remaining here in the first half. Gramlich, he'll check out his first break of the night as Gilbert will reinsert himself now into the game. Pass on in here by Burton. Oh, it's tipped away, and Hall will come away with it. Pass forward here to Peros. He rises and gets blocked, but fouled as he was trying to slam it on down. Peros was trying to blow the roof off of this place there and nearly did, but instead he'll head to the free throw line for two. I think a little bit of discussion going on here if they want to call this intentional foul or not. And they're going to go on ahead and review it. The foul was called on Ethan Gilbert. That's his second foul. And now they'll go on ahead and go to the tape to review this one to see if there is anything malicious about it. From my vantage point, it looked like Burton was trying to go up and go for the ball there. So it looked fairly clean, but it doesn't hurt to go on ahead and review it when you have the option to, like the officials have elected to do here. Well, it's going to be 10:08 remaining here on the game clock. And Rattler fans, we'll take this time to remind you that with the changing of the season, you're going to need to change up your clothes. So what better place to get new clothes than RattlerGear.com? With RattlerGear.com, you can support all of St. Mary's best gear and do it while you're supporting your favorite St. Mary's Rattlers. T-shirts, pants, shorts, whatever you need, and accessories too, just be sure to check out RattlerGear.com. They're still looking at the film on this one here. Unless they're reviewing something else, then it seems fairly straightforward. So they've now broken the huddle, and we're ready to get back to play from the looks of things here. And they will call it a common foul. Just two shots awarded here. Peros heading to the line. Peros averaging 8.3 points per game to go along with 2.4 assists and 4.6 rebounds. It's that first one put in. He was a starter at the beginning of the year, but since he's been moved into the role of a valuable bench player for the St. Mary's team as he sinks that first one. The second one, no good there as well, and the rebound will be taken down by Lilly. 17-15, the Rattler lead. This is one passed up top to Lilly, now swung around here for Burton. Pass it on over to Watkins. Over to Gramlich now. He's checked himself back into the game. Pass on out over towards Taylor. Back over to Taylor. Just 2 seconds on the shot clock right here. And they're going to put it up, but it won't be in time. A shot clock violation. And for St. Edward's, a really rough possession out of them. They weren't even really able to enter inside of that three-point line the entire time. Brooks, he'll check out of the game, and here comes Wetzel on in. Wetzel, one of the few Rattler bigs who's managed to keep himself out of foul trouble. Peterson, he also checked into the game during the last break. Looking for Wetzel here, can't find him. Now Jiminy has it up top. Pass is off. Here's Hall, a light floater shot off the backboard. Good for two. The biggest lead of the night for the Rattlers as they now lead it by four. That one booted there by Peros. Perhaps his soccer tryout, but it will just result in a Hilltopper possession. Still, though, that's worth doing if you're on the defensive end of things. You go on ahead, disrupt the flow of the other team. And it doesn't reset the shot clock, so no harm, no foul. This one passed in. Somehow coming up with it and finishing it is Taylor. There are three Rattler jerseys down there, but Taylor's the one who comes away with it in the end and finishes it for two. Givens up top now. He'll pass on off here to Hall. Back up to Givens. And you see a zone defense now coming out of the Hilltoppers. This one popped up, tipped again. Givens with it now, just 8 seconds on the shot clock. Wetzel trying to get fancy with the reverse, but no good there. And now here come the Hilltoppers the other way. Watkins, he goes up, no good there. Tried to draw the foul, but Peros kept it clean. Isaiah now going the other way. Pass off to Wetzel. He'll spin and now pass it off to Peterson. Off to Hall now, 4-3, that's good. Trey Hall, the nice shot there off of the scramble possession, and it's the Rattlers who come away as the beneficiaries. 8:08 remaining here in the first half. The Rattlers lead it by 5. Here's the drive and the finish with the foul out of Burton, his second and one already of the game. Bryce Smith, he'll check into the game for Givens. And then also checking into the game will be Lindsay, as he'll be replacing James Taylor. Burton already up to 7 points on the game here tonight. And he'll make it 8. He's now checking in will be Ethan Gilbert, as he'll be heading in for Watkins. Update on McBulu. We see him now over there kind of nearby the training table. He has his right arm in a sling, so it seems doubtful that he'll be returning to this one. We hope that he's just fine and this is something that can be solved in the day-to-day action. Pass on off to Hall now. That one up for 3, no good. No one touched it, so it will be last touched by St. Mary's. And now we have our final media, our third media timeout here of the half. We'll take the break with them here on the Rattler Network. And welcome back, everyone. 7:43 remaining here in the first half. It's Burton with the ball up top for the side of the Hilltoppers, as we have a foul called here down low. Does look like they're going to get Peterson here, as he might have been caught being too aggressive up against the side of Lily. And that's significant because it's going to be the 8th team foul committed by the Rattlers, and it'll be 1-1 the action here for the Hilltoppers the rest of the way. Lily, that first one, no good, and the board will be taken down by Wetzel. Bryce Smith brings it down the floor temporarily, but now he'll leave it for Trey Hall. Just 7:20 remaining here in the first half. Pass on off here to Peterson. That one, no good. He'll get his own rebound, though, and he'll draw the foul. So Peterson, he's going to be heading to the line after he earned that one by gaining the offensive board. Peterson averaging 4.5 points per game so far on the year. He makes that first one. Makes the lead on up to three now for St. Mary's. As checking out of the game will be Burton. He'll get himself a rest. And Watkins, after a brief breather, will check on back in. Peterson, he sinks them both. And now here comes Skylar Brooks off the bench. And you see the Rattlers, it looks like they decided during that last break that they're going to apply some more full court pressure here. Oh, a dangerous pass there. Peros, oh, he thought he got ball, but unfortunately also managed to trip up Watkins a little bit. And Watkins, he comes up a little bit gingerly now as he's grasping at that left shoulder, but appears he'll be just fine, and still just 1-1 the situation here for the Hilltoppers. First shot from Watkins is good. You can see St. Edward's, they're very confident in Watkins to make both of these as they have nobody in the box right now. And he misses the second one, and the rebound is taken down by Brooks. So here comes Bryce Smith. Now it is a zone defense out of St. Edward's now. They've been mixing it in on occasion. Up top to Brooks. And now Peros, he'll shoot a three. That one no good. Brooks, he'll battle for it, tip it to himself, shoot the three-pointer, airballs it, hauls up with it. He'll get rejected there by Gramlich, the point guard coming in to swat that one away. 6:45 remaining here in the first. Smith, he'll be the trigger man here. Passes it out to Peros, well up top. Still that zone defense from the Hilltoppers. Brooks, a turnaround jumper, no good there from the free throw line. But it bounces around and will find its way into the hands of Trey Hall. Now they'll try to work it down low. It is Woodhill, Wetzel in there, and he'll draw himself a foul. And Yanni now will head to the line. That foul, the sixth team foul committed by the side of the Hilltoppers, and also the second personal foul committed by Trey Lindsay. Wetzel, 4 points already on the night, and he'll have to sit on those four for just a little bit longer. For St. Mary's, it was a little bit of a slow start coming out of things. They trailed the game early, 8-2, but since then have really managed to battle their way on back as Wetzel, he'll get the second one to go. This one, oh, the press broken very quickly. Gramlich, he's going to let it fly, and that one is good. They're going to signal to go on ahead and review that one, but for now it will be counting 4-3. Smith with the ball up top over to Peros. And now Hall with it. Oh, bad pass there, Lindsay. He picked it off with ease. Here we go the other way now. It's Watkins. He'll pass it on off to Lily. Gramlich with it now into Lindsay. Going over toward the diving Lily. And now just down to 15 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Again, the Rattlers getting in the passing lane. They have two players over to double Lindsay, but because of that and two bounce passes later, Lily, he's going to have the easy shot for two there. 5:30 remaining here in the first half, and St. Edward's the lead back in hand for them. Step back. And that one is good, 4-2. Watkins bringing it on down the floor. Passes it off for Lindsay, and we're gonna get a foul called here down low. Brooks, it looks like he might have been bumping up against Lily a bit too much, and that'll be the 10th team foul committed by the side of the Hilltoppers. First shot by Lily, no good there. So now here comes Christian Miner now. So he'll check in and Peros will check out. Miner, he had himself and an extended break. So that one no good as well. So, and now a timeout will be taken by the side of St. Mary's. We'll take the break with them. The Rattlers lead by one. .502 remaining in the first half. Possession on over to the Rattlers. Coach Zelsnak probably electing to draw something on up for his side as Hall with it right now. Maybe something trying to work against this zone defense. Pass on over to Miner. And now they're going to send Miner and Brooks on through. Here comes the pick and roll. Smith, pass on out to Miner. This one for three is no good, as Gramlich will be coming down with the rebound. This one is shot up, no good, as it will be on the floor. And heading to the line for two will be Gilbert, as it looked like he got blocked there in his process by Wetzel. Wetzel, only his first foul, though, on the night. The Rattler big man. So far, really the only one who's been able to keep out of foul trouble. As that one is put in there by Gilbert. He'll tie things back on up. Lindsay, he'll check on out of the game, and checking in will be Alex Doce. And that one good as well, as once again the back and forth affair continues. Here's Smith now, he'll pass it on off to Miner. Brooks, he's had that turnaround jumper option all night, but this time he'll pass it on out. But no good there out of Bryce Smith. Here's Gramlich now, bringing it down the floor. Over to Watkins. First time that Doce has touched the ball. He'll pass it on out, and now here's Watkins, good for three. The four-point advantage now for the Hilltoppers. Really, neither team breaking away from one another. I think the biggest lead on the night has just been six. Pass on into Brooks, once again to that high post. And the good ball movement will result in the open three there for Brooks, as the Rattlers will get those points right on back. And you see just what inserting the ball into the high post will do up against a zone defense. Once you do that, you're able to make one or two more passes, and more often than not, you're going to have yourself an open shooter. Once again, working up against that zone defense. Smith passes it over to Hall. This time they put it on into the post. Kick out pass. Hall this time for three. That one is no good. The long rebound will be taken down by Watkins. Oh, Olay defense there as that one put up, but no good as Brooks was able to get back there. Here's Hall now. Pass on off to Wetzel. The bang and the foul to boot. Wetzel puts the Rattlers up and chance for one more as he'll head now to the line. But first, our final media timeout of the half. We'll take the break with them. Rattlers lead it by one. 3:02 remaining here in the first half. It's a lead of one here for St. Mary's. I think now that they've had a chance with immediate timeout, they're going to go back and review that transition three-pointer that Gramlich had. It seems like quite a while back, they scored a three-pointer at the time for him as he knocked it down in transition. They don't review those types of things until there is immediate timeout. Unfortunately, I think for the officials, they have reviewed it and changed it to a two. I saw the official signaling there. So it was the shot by Gramlich, so it's now going to be a two-point advantage for the side of the Rattlers. The angle that they have is the one that we provide, but for St. Mary's, turns out they will be the beneficiary of that right there. Head coach Andre Cook wanting an explanation, but I mean, he's being given one. I mean, that's just what they saw. As now Wetzel, he'll be heading to the line. Very good that we are able to provide that footage to the officials. Wetzel, he'll make it a three-point game now, as turns out that 1 point might actually be a nice little difference maker, especially in a game that's been as tightly contested as this one. So here's Burton now with the ball up top, working against Hall. He'll pass it off to Lilly in the high post. Back to Burton now. St. Mary's, they've been sticking with that man-to-man defense, as I think that Hall might have gotten a piece of that one, but now an offensive foul drawn to boot as Brooks stepped in there. That'll be the second personal foul committed by Burton. He's going to have to be careful from here on out. And also it'll be the eighth team foul that'll be committed by the side of the Hilltoppers. So just two away from the double bonus. On the floor for the Rattlers, they have Wetzel, Brooks, Hall, Smith, and Miner. And then meanwhile over there for the Hilltoppers, it's going to be Gramlich, Doche, Lilly, Gilbert, and Burton. Pass up top, here's to Hall, and we're going to get a foul committed right there. That's going to be the ninth team foul up against the Hilltoppers. They're going to get Doche right there for being a bit too physical down in the paint up against Wetzel. And Yanni now, he'll head to the line. He already has himself 7 points on the night. Yanni, 1 for 2 from that foul line today. He's 3 of 5 from the floor, as he'll put in point number 8 for St. Mary's. A 4-point advantage now for the Rattlers. Neither team in this one leading by any more than 6 on the night. It's been a super competitive game all the way through. Very much like the ladies game that we saw earlier. St. Edward's at one point in that game managed to pull ahead by double digits, but it never got beyond that point. The Rattlers, of course, able to battle back and win that one. Here's Gramlich now up top, working up against Smith. Gets a screen from Doche. Now Doche on the pop. He'll stutter. Try to pass it into Lilly, but good active hands there by Hall. You see Smith, the game manager that he is, always looking up at that clock, making sure he has his Rattlers in a good position here. Passes it off to Miner now. Now here's Skylar Brooks, and Rattlers seem content to run some time off the clock here as they're now just down to 10 seconds here and really haven't initiating anything in the offense. Now down to 5 seconds. Here's Miner. Big hop, step. He'll power on through. Get the finish for a 2. 6 points the lead now for the guys in gold. And Lilly, he'll call a timeout. 24 seconds will be on the game clock. 1:32 will be on the game clock. 24 on the shot clock, I should say. We'll go ahead and take this brief break with them. 1:32 on the game clock. The Hilltoppers already have broken their lineup. They actually had six on the floor temporarily right there, but quickly able to fix that situation. For St. Mary's, they've done an excellent job on the boards here tonight. They have 19, while the Hilltoppers only have 13. Here's a screen here from Lily. Watkins got challenged by Brooks, I believe that was, and Brooks managed to come away with the block right there, or at the very least just altered the shot so much. Here's Wetzel now working his way on in. Hilltoppers bench, they wanted themselves a turnover. And now here's Wetzel trying to work the spin move, spin through again, the left-handed scoop for two, and it's now an 8-point advantage for St. Mary's, the biggest lead that either team has had all night. Down to 50 seconds here on the game clock, 20 on the shot clock. Passed on through. Gramlich had temporarily, and now it's over to Watkins. Up here now to Burton, and a blocking foul called there. Miner was close to being in position to draw the charge, but now it'll be two free throws over to Burton and the Hilltoppers. For Miner, though, only his first personal foul on the night. So he's sitting in a nice situation. That first one, no good there. And with 40.1 seconds remaining here on the game clock, you would think that the Rattlers would go on ahead and elect to run as much time as they can. It's the second one, no good as well. And Wetzel, he'll take down the rebound. So 0-2 trip for St. Edward's here. Now here's Bryce Smith. St. Mary's, they can't work a two-for-one in this situation, so they'll probably just elect to get the best shot they can. Here's Wetzel now, trying to work in the post again, but he picked up his dribble. He's got deep position right now, but can't be in that paint for too long. Here's the pass now from Brooks. Down to 4 seconds on the shot clock. Smith is going to have to force something up. Oh, a bad foul there by Watkins. He's going to send Bryce Smith to the line, and it's now double bonus for the Rattlers. And after playing 27 seconds of good defense out of the side of the Hilltoppers, Watkins commits his third foul and now sends Smith to the line for two freebies. First one is good for Bryce, his first point on the night. St. Mary's overall, they've been to that free throw line a ton in this first half. They're now 9 of 17. As Peros, he'll be checking into the game for Wetzel. It looks like Coach Selznack electing to go with a smaller lineup here for the final 11 seconds, especially when it appears that there might be some scrambling defense to be played. So now down to 11 seconds. Here's Watkins now. Watkins down to 6 seconds. Now here off to Gramlich. 3 seconds for Gramlich. The floater, that one bouncing around, tipped up and good by Burton. And that'll do it for the first half. The offensive board plus the putback for two will cut the lead down to 8. But the Rattlers still comfortably in the lead as we conclude the first half. They really did well getting to the free throw line and rebounding as well. 21-14 in that rebounding spot. And then they're also shooting very efficiently from the floor, 51.9% for the Rattlers. We'll take a quick break, but when we return, the second half here on the Rattler Network.
So go ahead and throw it back live.
Yeah.
All right.